In this video, we're going to change a single socket like that for a double socket. The problem with a single socket is that people tend to plug stupid things like these in. So that is some kind of extender which enables you to plug in four items into the one socket. If we switch that off and take a look in there, you can see that the socket is already damaged, where somebody has actually walked past and bang that piece which has broken the socket. So things like this are very dangerous. I really would not recommend using something like that. So we're going to swap this one for a double one. This is relatively easy in this wall because this is drywall. If you have a solid wall, it is a little bit more difficult. I will put a link down in the description that shows you how to cut out a back box like this in a traditional wall, which does take quite a bit longer. So the first thing we need to do is plug something like that in, switch on the socket to ensure that it is energized. We're now going to go to the consumer unit and we're going to isolate the circuit that feeds this socket. I'm now at the consumer unit. I'm going to look for the MCB that does the downstairs sockets, which is this one. And then I'm going to use a lock off device to lock that in the off position. And that will prevent anybody from switching that circuit back on again. So you can see that the light has now gone out. So we're just going to remove the two screws that hold this to the wall. We can then carefully pull that away from the wall. And before we touch any of the wires, we're going to ensure that they are completely dead by using this GS38 approved voltage tester. To start off with, we're going to ensure this is working by pressing the auto test button, which it is. We're then going to check the continuity of the leads by doing a resistance test. So you can see that the tester is working. We're going to take the negative probe. I'm going to put that on the earthing terminal, but then I'm going to probe the live, which is dead, and also the neutral. And it is important that you make good contact with the terminals when you do this. So you can now be sure that that is safely isolated. We're now just going to check that the tester is still working by pressing the auto test button. And then I'm just going to press the Holmes button and touch the probes together. And that shows us that the leads are still working. So it is now safe to continue. I'm now going to undo the three wires, the live, the neutral and the earth. This is relatively easy to do because this is just a spur, so it only has one cable going in the back there. Some sockets do have two or three cables going in, so this is relatively straightforward. Unfortunately, somebody's papered over the actual box itself, so we'd have to mess about a bit here and just remove some of the paper from around the box. What we don't want to do is tear the paper back too far. So now we've done that, we can now push back on the tabs on the inside. And we'll push them back as far as they will go. And then we're just going to force them to the middle of the back box. Effectively what I've done there is pushed back on that tab, so it's gone all the way back. And then I've pressed it in like so. That will enable me to pull that box out. So I can now just take a screwdriver and I can just get that behind the box and I can just lever that out. What we want to be careful of is damaging the wallpaper too much. So now that's out, we can now just feel up the back of there and ensure that there's nothing that's going to obstruct where we're going to cut. Obviously in this scenario we can't actually go that way because we've got another fuse connection unit there which is controlling something else. So in this option we can only go in that one direction. So I've just had a feel up the back of there and there's nothing in the way, although there is a bit of insulation in the cavity. This circuit is actually RCD protected, so I'm just going to put some insulation tape over the end of the live wire there. And I'll also just cover the neutral and the earth, just so that if these touch, it doesn't actually trip out the RCD, because I only want this one circuit to be isolated and not all of them. So that'll just prevent any of the wires from touching. I'm now just going to push that back inside the cavity. So I'm just going to put the back box in there. I'm just going to mark down this side. Then to get the top and bottom lines in, I'm going to use the spirit level to ensure that we get the lines level. So that is the extra portion that we need to cut out before the double back box will fit in there. Obviously there's going to be a lot of dust when we do this, so I'm just going to take a rubble sack and I'm just going to tape that on there using some masking tape, and that will collect all of the dust. I'm now going to take a drywall saw and we're simply going to cut out that pencil line. Now just try that in the hole. You can see that that is a nice tight fit. So I'm just going to shave a little bit off this edge here. And I'll just try the box again. And that should go in there absolutely no problem at all. So we're now going to get the wires back. We're now going to feed them through the bottom of the back box. We can then push the back box into the hole. Now that we've done that, we can now remove the rubble sack. We can now push the tabs in and just pull them forwards. Once the socket is screwed in there, that will then pull tight onto the drywall or plasterboard, and that will hold it tight against the plasterboard. We can now take the new socket and check where the earth, neutral and live connections are. So we'll just undo the screws on those. We can then take these wires and put these back into the socket. So we'll start off with the earth wire. I'm going to push that into the earthing terminal and then tighten the screw. Then just check that that's tight by trying to pull it out. We can then reconnect the neutral. Of course, you don't need to put this insulation tape on if your sockets are not RCD protected, but this was just to stop them tripping out whilst I pushed it inside of the cavity. We can now reconnect the neutral wire. So we'll push that into the terminal and then tighten it up fully. And then finally the live wire. So that goes into the live terminal. Okay, and just install that in there and just tighten up the terminal screw. So we'll just check that all three terminals are tight, and then we'll just check them by trying to pull them out. Obviously, if you pull them out, you've not put them in properly in the first place. So we now just need to ensure that no wires are going to get caught. We can then push that back against the wall. We can then replace the fixing screws. We'll then just ensure that that is level. We can put a spirit level on there and we can just adjust it until it is level before we tighten up the screws fully. Now we've done that, we can go and de-isolate the electric. Now that we've done the work, we can remove the lock. And we can switch the circuit breaker back on. The test that I'm using indicates that the earth, live and neutral are wired correctly. So we can now remove that. So that is how to replace a single socket like that with a double socket. I'd like to thank you for watching this video. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the channel.